For me, my day usually starts at 9 o'clock in the center, so then do a little warm up with the elastic, and then I'll shoot. The morning, I will shoot around 100 to 200 arrows, short distance with the video delay, just to like get the shot feeling and really work on the technical aspects. If I'm not working on technical aspects, I will also shoot short distance because it really helps to reinforce the correct tree. I started archery quite late. I started completely by chance because we were on holidays in Italy in a camping ground, and there was a couple activities you could do, and among them it was archery. And from the moment I started doing it, I told my parents I want to go back to this stand every day.
Matteo has a very strong mind, and when he said something, he goes 100% to it. It grew into me, the archery as well. I mean, but when your kid is on the line and every arrow is like a definitive thing, so it's really, really emotional. So.
What I like is that it's such a simple motion. Because it's not like football, it's not like volleyball where you have many different motions. It's just one motion. And it's the same motion every time. But you need a level of precision in this motion, which for me is incredible.
Ses forces, c'est surtout la persévérance qu'il a dans l'entraînement, sur les différents éléments qu'on peut mettre en place à l'entraînement, que ce soit sur le plan physique, sur le plan technique, sur le plan mental. Il a cette force de résilience où il va avoir envie de toujours faire plus. Mais c'est aussi ses défauts et ses points de faiblesse, c'est que c'est un grand perfectionniste et il a toujours à cœur de vouloir faire mieux. Et par moments, pour lui, le point de progression vraiment que je peux avoir avec Matteo, bah, c'est accepter de pouvoir faire les choses des fois juste simplement sans vouloir des fois aller chercher la perfection.
I am studying life science engineering in my first year bachelor. I chose EPFL primarily because it had the World Archery Excellence Center very close by. Something I really like is the applicability of the study, because if you look at the future job market that you could have, there's a lot of interest, for example, in pharmacology and research. So in the end, with this, you can have a job in a lab doing experiments, which is something I'm really, really looking forward to. The thing which is most difficult is time management, because you need to split your time, but in the end, you only have so many hours in a week. So then there's always this balance between how much should I invest into school, how much should I invest into training, and organizing and really planning out how this works, for me, has been the most challenging part so far.
Supporting your son in these competing in high-level competitions and studying as well is not hard. I do worry sometimes because both of them require a lot of dedication and a lot of time. And of course I do get a bit worried that he will overdo But he's doing a great job, I must say. He has been very capable in managing his time, and I just feel very proud of what he is achieving.
For me this season, the primary goal is the World University Games, which is really good because then I can take certain risks, I can do certain technical changes, even if it's not a traditional time to do these changes, because I know that the goal is set and at this time. So I know, okay, this technical change will take this much time, but I know that this is when I have to shoot good. So then I can plan it in a way which I couldn't if it weren't my main goal. It's such a beautiful sport because it's simple, it's relaxing, and the feeling of shooting a 10 under pressure with wind is unparalleled.